Hello guys, my name is Alex Gomez and on today's video we're gonna be talking about tips to improve your sculpting. For more sculpting videos, tips and techniques and anything related with the 3D industry, subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell to be notified when I post a video every Friday. So while showing my process of sculpting Leo the Professional, one of my favorite movies, I want to talk about some tips that is going to help you improve your sculpting techniques. The first tip that I always mention in probably my old videos, and I always tell my students as well, is to gather references. The more references you gather, the better the results you'll see. You're going to have a better idea about proportions, you're going to have a better idea about the subject matter that you're sculpting. Don't just focus on gather reference. For example, if you're sculpting a head or a skull per se, gather reference broad and in detail. So big reference, for example, the whole skull, and a small reference to some details in the nostrils, in the eye sockets, where the teeth goes, where the cheekbones. So that kind of difference of reference is going to give you a better idea about proportions, as well as a better idea about the details and how those details interconnect with the proportions. The more reference you gather, the better. You can use free software like PureRef. I totally recommend it to gather all your references and put them there. It's easy to navigate. It's a free software. You can put it on top, set it up as you can see it on top of the screen. So it's gonna be, for example, on top of your YouTube. I have some videos that I have shown like how to use it. And I definitely recommend it to gather your reference and put it in the same place. You can gather your reference through ArtStation, through Pinterest, Google Images, so on. So the sky is the limit for you guys to gather the reference, but reference is one of the most important things if you guys want to improve your sculpting. You cannot improve your sculpting if you are not using references. Another tip that I want to mention is that you have to set yourself up for failure. You have to fail a lot of times in order to learn. You cannot expect that you're gonna be sculpting and you're gonna get great results right away. That's where it becomes practice, and practice is so important. The idea of set up yourself for failure is that you're gonna, for example, sculpt a hand, and you're gonna sculpt a hand over and over. If you want to improve how you're gonna sculpt a hand, you have to sculpt the same hand, like in an hour one day, in an hour the next day, in an hour the next day. You're gonna do the hand like 5, 6, 10 times, depends on your skills, but then it's gonna become so natural and it's gonna become with muscle memory that your sculpt is gonna be better. It's gonna be easier for you because you are ready, like your mind knows the proportions, your mind knows the techniques and the workflow to develop that hand or that subject matter that you're working on. And you're gonna keep every single image or every single sculpt in that process that you're in your practice process. For example, day one hand, day two another hand, day three another hand, and you're gonna keep up kind of like a journey or an image of every single time that you're sculpting a hand, and you're gonna start comparing and you're gonna give it another try, and you're gonna see that by the 10th time you're gonna sculpt the subject matter like much better, like either a hand or an ear or an eye or a face or a full character. But you have to do that practice and spending an hour, 2 hours, 3 hours a day, depending on what you want to improve. And this is where we come back into references. And you, when you have all your images of your progress by day 10, you're gonna compare not only your own images, but your images to your references. So your image from day one to your reference, and your image from day 10, sorry, for your to your references as well. And you're gonna going to start having that understanding of proportions and not just on proportions, but also you're gonna start training your eye to interpretate or to sculpt what you see. Because even though in those practices you're gonna be learning some anatomy and some shapes, you're going to interpret what you're seeing into your digital sculpts, and that's one of the most important things. That's why you have to use reference, because you have to be able to interpret what you're seeing and put it in your digital sculpts. Because there's nothing about like learning anatomy if you cannot put it in your work, if you cannot represent the shapes and forms that you are seeing. Another tip that I have for you guys to improve your sculpting is also looking for feedback. Look for feedback from people in social media, people in ZBrush groups or sculpting, digital sculpting groups. And I know, I understand sometimes it's hard to put like a shitty piece or a like a like you know like an ugly piece of art, but who cares, you know? Like, I know people are gonna hate, and haters gonna be haters, and you're gonna find haters everywhere. But put yourself out there and ask, hey, this is my first sculpt, this is my second sculpt, I'm just learning, I'm trying to improve. Any feedback that you guys can tell me? Obviously, a lot of feedback is, oh, you should learn anatomy, but you already know in my previous tip. So, but yeah, I ask for feedback, and also give feedback yourself. So, kind of like a step outside of your digital sculpt area, and then put your image or your digital sculpt, compare it to your reference, and compare the two of them, and then you're gonna see what is going on. Let's say if you're sculpting a head or a face, you say, oh, the mouth is not right where it should be. So be very critical to your own work. I know sometimes feel that you need to keep improving, improving the same piece, but don't do it. If you finish, finish it and move on to the next one. And when you move to the next one, you're gonna see that you're gonna improve what you saw as mistakes in the first piece. So set up yourself for mistakes. Like make mistakes, not on purpose, but you're gonna make mistakes. But you're gonna see those mistakes that are gonna be improving. And once you see your first images in that journey that you're keeping, you're definitely gonna be more critical to your work, and definitely you're gonna see the mistakes that you used to make, and now that you're improving in those areas. Another tip that I want to mention is not a tip, but it's kind of like a piece of advice. And just remember that it's not about the tool, it's about the fundamentals. You can even practice with clay and make a muscle, an arm, a torso, or you can use Play-Doh and do it. And it's just about the fundamentals. If you can do it with your hands, I'm very sure you can do it digitally as well. You can learn the tool, you can learn Blender for sculpting, you can learn ZBrush, you can, I don't know if there's another sculpting or Maya sculpting, which I don't like. But the thing is, like, you can learn the tool, but if you don't know the fundamentals, like, you're gonna be stuck, and you really need to understand that for every single sculpting, even if it's real sculpting, like traditional sculpting, there is different phases. There is a phase of block out, there is a phase of refining and working with proportions, and also there is a phase of detailing your characters or your models. So remember, like, you can be a master of ZBrush, and you can know all the single tools in ZBrush. I don't know, like, there's so many stuff about ZBrush tools that I don't know, but my sculpts are good. I think is because I just focus more on the fundamentals than of what can I do with this tool, or know how this tool is gonna help me or not. I just pretty much use the same brushes and the same tools and the same workflow. But sometimes if I feel stuck, I probably will ask someone. But remember that it's about the fundamentals, because if you have those fundamentals of doing digital sculpting in ZBrush, you can move that to Blender and you can move that to traditional clay. But it's just about fundamentals, like how you block out, how you detail the characters, how you add more details, how you work on secondary shapes. So just remember about those tips that I that I mentioned to you guys, and if you practice like that, like every day, you're gonna see that you're gonna improve your skills a lot and your art is gonna become much better. So if you like this video, please like, comment and subscribe, and don't forget to watch my other two videos right here, and have an amazing weekend, guys. See you next Friday. Take care.